Okay, so today we are going to discuss chapter construction, and we'll continue the topic tangent to a circle. In this particular question, the angle between the tangents are given in the question, and the radius of the tangent is given, and we have to draw the given construction. So for this, first of all, we'll do the planning. We will draw a rough sketch. First, with the help of compass, we'll draw a circle of radius 5 cm. Let's say this is a circle of radius 5 cm, and this is the point P, which is a point on the exterior of the circle, and we need to draw two tangents from this point P. Let's say PA and PB are the two tangents. Okay, if we join this point A, A is the point of contact of this tangent with the exterior of the circle. If we join this point A with the center O, and as well as B, point B with center O. So this OA is the radius, and OB is also the radius of the circle. The angle between the tangent is given 60 degree, so PA and PB are the tangents, so angle between the tangents will be this angle. This is given 60 degree. Obviously the angle between tangent and the radius is 90 degree. As we all know, I have already told that we have studied in chapter circles that at point of contact, the tangent between the angle between the tangent and radius is 90 degree, or we can say that radius is perpendicular to the tangent. So this angle, that is angle AOB, we can calculate by angle sum property of quadrilateral. So this angle AOB will be equal to angle P plus angle P, angle AOB plus angle P plus angle A plus angle B. Sum of the angles of quadrilateral will be 360 degree. We can substitute the values. AOB plus 60 plus 90 plus 90, that is 360 degree. So angle AOB will be equal to 360 minus of 180 plus 60 will be 240. Then subtracting, we are getting 120 degree. So the measure of angle AOB is 120 degree. Okay, this is 120 degree. So how we are going to do this? First we'll draw the circle of radius 5 cm. It is given 5 cm radius. Then we will draw with the help of compass the angle of 120 degree, and we'll draw another radius. So OA and OB will be the two radius. Then from point A and point B, that is the point of contact, we'll draw perpendiculars using compass only. So we will be getting two tangents, AP and BP, and this will be meeting at point P. In this way we will complete our construction. So this is our plan of action or the rough sketch. Now we shall start with our construction. So we will take the radius equal to 5 cm. Okay, compass, and we are using compass and ruler. We are taking the radius equals to 5 cm. Let's say this is point O. With O as the center, taking radius equal to 5 cm, we'll draw a circle. Okay, like this. Now we will make a radius. We'll join this point O with the circumference to get the radius okay, this is point A. So we have got OA, and OA is the radius of the circle. This radius you can draw anywhere, it is up to you. Now with O as the center, taking some convenient radius. Don't take very small radius, because if you take a small radius, then it will be difficult for you to make the arcs. Okay, so some convenient radius, and with O as the center, draw a semicircular arc, then draw the arc of 60 degree and the 120 degree. So we have got the point. Let us name this point as X. Now we will join O to X and produce it till it meet the circumference of the circle. So in this way we have got the other radii of the circle. We have got the other radii of the circle, and we'll name this as point P. Now what? Now at point A, we will draw 90 degree in order to make a tangent at point A. Point A will be the point of contact. So this is arc of 60 and arc of 120. Then with radius more than half, we'll draw an arc which intersect each other in this way, and we will join it and we will get the tangent. This is the required tangent. Now similar manner, at point B we will draw semicircle, and we will draw the arc of 60 and the arc of 120. Then with more than half of radius, we will draw arcs so that we get 90 degree at this point, and we will join them. So like this, so we will be getting the tangent BP. So this will be the point P. This is the point P. Okay. So in this way we will complete our construction. Okay. Now if we want to write the steps of construction, let us discuss. So we have done the same thing. We have drawn a circle of radius 5 cm. Draw radius OA equal to the radius OA of the circle. Then with O as the center, we have taken the compass and we have drawn the arc of 60, 120, and we will mark this as point X. Joining OX, produce it to B such that B is the point of contact. Now at A, we have drawn 90 degree and produce it. And at B also similarly, we will draw 90 degree and produce it such that it is intersecting at point P. Then AP and BP are the required tangent. AP and BP are required tangent. Okay. AP and BP are the required tangents. Okay. Now we need to justify the construction also. If we want to justify the construction, how can we justify it? Similar as we have done in the previous question, in the similar manner we can justify this construction also. Like we can say that OB and OA are radius of the circle, they are the radii of the circle, and angle OBP is equal to angle OAP is equal to 90 degree by construction. and we already know that at the point of contact, that is B and A, if we are drawing perpendiculars to the radius, then the required line segments therefore will be BP and AP will be the tangents. Okay, in this way we have completed the construction in this question. Let us move to the next question then.